Hi friends, welcome to today's class. So today's question is, a boat can draw 30 km upstream and 44 km downstream in 10 hours. Also, it can draw 55 km downstream and 40 km upstream in 13 hours. Find the rate of current and the speed of boat in still water. So what is the given question? So here, the distances traveled upstream and downstream are given. And the total time taken is also given. You have to find out the rate of current and the speed of boat in still water. Or you have to find out X and Y. So upstream distance, downstream distance and the times are given. You have to find out. So now I am trying to write it as a table. So first the boat is rowing 30 km upstream and 44 km downstream. And the total time taken is 10 hours. All these are kilometers, okay, distance traveled. So upstream distance traveled is 30 km and the downstream distance traveled is 44 km and the total time is 10 hours. And second case, 55 km upstream and 40 km downstream and the total time taken is 13 hours. You have to find out X and Y, where X and Y represent the standard notations. X is equal to speed of boat in still water and Y is equal to rate of current. So the question may seem complex. So I am going to give a shortcut formula for doing these kind of questions. So be thorough with the format of the question. The distance traveled upstream and the distance traveled downstreams are given and the total time taken is also given. 30 km upstream, 44 km downstream and the time taken is 10 hours. 40 km upstream and 55 km should come here. Okay, so given 55 km downstream and 40 km upstream. The table should be correct. So 40 km upstream and 55 km downstream in 13 hours. So you are asked to find out X and Y. So how to do this? So upstream speed and downstream speed you can find out by this shortcut formula. So upstream speed I am going to write it as USS and downstream speed I will be writing as DSS, just for our easiness. So upstream speed will be equal to, how to do is that you have to do the cross multiplication here. 30 into 55 and 40 into 44 and you have to take the difference. The answer should be positive. So that way you have to take. So here 40 into 44 will be greater than 30 into 55. So 40 into 44 minus 30 into 55. The distances traveled upstream and downstream, you have to take the cross product. And even for downstream speed also, the numerator will be same. So it will be easy to remember. The numerator will be same for both upstream speed and downstream speed, which will be equal to the difference between the cross products of the upstream and the downstream distances. So here also it will come 40 into 44 minus 30 into 55. Now denominator, now it's time for denominator. When you are asked to find out the upstream speed, you have to consider the downstreams. So that is the difference here. When you are asked to find out the upstream speed, you have to take the cross product between the downstream distances and downstream time. So it will be, you have to take the cross product here. For the first case, the upstream speed will be equal to the difference between the cross products of the downstream distance and the time. The time should be there and the cross product will be just the opposite. For finding out upstream speed, you have to take the cross product with downstream distance. So there also positive quantity should come. So 44 into 13 minus 55 into 10. And for downstream speed, you have to consider the upstream distances and the cross products. So this cross product only you have to consider. So 40 into 10 minus 13 into 30. All the quantities should be positive. So any order you can take, only the answer should be positive. So this will give you the upstream speed and the downstream speed. So 40 into 44 minus 30 into 55 is 110 and 44 into 13 minus 55 into 10 is equal to 22. So upstream speed is equal to 110 divided by 22, which gives you 5 km per hour. And downstream speed will be equal to 40 into 44 minus 30 into 55 is 110 And 14 to 10 minus 13 to 13 will be equal to 400 minus 390, which gives you 10. So it will be 11 kilometer per hour. So you have the upstream speed and downstream speed now. So what is x? X will be equal to half into upstream speed plus downstream speed, which gives you half into 11 plus 5. Half into 16 is equal to 8 kilometer per hour. And y will be equal to half into upstream speed minus downstream speed minus upstream speed, which gives you half into 11 minus 5, so half into 6, that is 3 kilometer per hour. So this is the final answer: rate of current and speed of boat in still water. So we will be doing one more problem, so you will be understanding more. So second question: Arunima covers 24 km upstream and 36 km downstream in 6 hours, while she covers 36 km upstream and 24 km downstream in 6.5 hours. Find the velocity of Arunima in still water and the current. So same kind of question. X and Y are asked. Velocity of Arunima in still water is X and the speed of current is equal to Y. So you have to find out X and Y. Here also the distances are given: the upstream distance, the downstream distance, and the total time is also given. So you can form the table. So upstream, downstream, and time. So 24 km upstream and 36 km downstream in 6 hours, and then 36 km upstream and 24 km downstream in 6.5 hours. So you have to find out X and Y. So how to do this? We are having shortcut formulas for upstream speed and downstream speed. Upstream speed will be equal to, you have to find out the cross product here. Cross product between the distances, upstream and the downstream distances, and the difference of the cross product. So you will be getting 36 into 36 minus 24 into 24. And when you are asked to find out the upstream speed, you have to take the difference between the cross products of downstream distance and the time. It should be positive. So 36 into 6.5 minus 24 into 6. So which gives you 36 square minus 24 square, which will be equal to 36 plus 24 into 36 minus 24. So you'll be getting 720. And 36 into 6.5 minus 24 into 6, which gives you 9. So upstream speed is given as 8 kilometer per hour. Now you can find out the downstream speed. Downstream speed will be equal to, numerator is same, so you can just write the numerator as such: 36 into 36 minus 24 into 24. And what about the denominator? You have to consider the cross products of upstream distance and the time, and then you have to take the difference. So it should be positive. So 36 into 6 minus 24 into 6.5, which gives you 720 divided by 60 is the denominator. So 720 by 60 is 12 kilometer per hour. Now we are having the upstream speed and the downstream speed. Now it's time to find out X and Y. So what is X? X is equal to half into upstream speed plus downstream speed, which gives you half into 12 plus 8, which is equal to half into 20, that is 10 kilometer per hour. And what is Y? Y is equal to half into downstream speed minus upstream speed, which gives you half into 12 minus 8, so half into 4, that is 2 kilometer per hour. So just understand the concept of this shortcut. Just form a table, find out the cross product, find out the difference, write it as numerator by denominator format, and you will be able to find out the upstream speed and the downstream speed. Once you get USS and DSS, you can easily find out X and Y. Thank you for watching.